This week in Louisiana agriculture.
The fight against the boll weevil may be over in Louisiana, but it's prompted another fight here. I'm Avery Davidson with that story ahead.
Also, could year-round hog hunting be in Louisiana's future? Some say it could solve the problem of these destructive animals. And in Holly Clegg's Trim and Terrific Kitchen, Holly and AJ bring chicken and Louisiana rice together for an easy casserole. Hello everyone, I'm Michael Dana. Thanks for joining us on this week's program. The boll weevil may no longer be a problem for Louisiana cotton farmers, but the money used to kill the bug is now causing some problems down at the state capitol. Following a statement from Commissioner of Agriculture and Forestry Dr. Mike Strain 2 weeks ago that the state had successfully eradicated the boll weevil, some lawmakers began eyeing the Boll Weevil Eradication Fund as a way to fill some state budget gaps. This week in Louisiana Agriculture's Avery Davidson shows us what happened next.
The boll weevil is no longer causing problems in Louisiana cotton fields, but it is prompting discussions here at the state capitol. Recently, members of the legislature and state government eyed money in the Boll Weevil Eradication Fund to fill holes in Louisiana's Medicaid budget to the tune of more than $700,000. After all, Commissioner of Agriculture and Forestry Dr. Mike Strain announced that the boll weevil was eradicated from Louisiana cotton fields, but Strain is quick to point out that's not the state's money.
This is the farmer's money. It's a voluntary assessment, a form of assistance. The farmers put up $6 an acre. They voted it on themselves. They sent it to us to be good stewards of their money, to do surveillance, and then to attack the boll weevil should it come back. We survey cotton acres, non-cotton acres, random acres, the experiment stations. We also intercept equipment coming in from areas that are boll weevil infested. There's still boll weevils in Texas that has not crossed the Rio Grande. But this is the farmer's money.
Strain says of the $167 million spent over the last 11 years to eradicate the boll weevil, more than $66 million came from farmers. That's why Senator Francis Thompson of Delhi filed a bill to protect the Boll Weevil Eradication Fund in the future. It's already passed the Senate, and it's on its way to the House.
I know money is tight, tighter than I've ever seen it in my three or more decades here, but this is probably the best investment of state dollars that I've ever seen.
We need to support any legislation or any concept that protects that money for the reason it was assessed. It was agreed upon to be assessed to keep that program intact.
Louisiana Farm Bureau Legislative Specialist Joe Mapes and Assistant to the President Jim Monroe agree the farmers' money should be protected. That's because the boll weevil eradication program has worked so well in the past and could be needed at any time in the future.
We've worked really hard to eliminate the boll weevil and been very successful. But part of that program is that you have to continue monitoring each year, and if you find any, you have to attack them quickly and with great vigor.
If it comes back, it's a $3 to $5 million problem if we identify it right away and attack it.
Strain points out that agriculture is the fastest growing industry in Louisiana, bringing in nearly $11 billion a year to the state.
The majority of our funds are self-generated. To hamper our ability to carry out our mission will result in a negative result and slow down the commerce of this state and decrease the actual taxes coming into the state.
And every legislator here knows that would be bad for Louisiana. In Baton Rouge, I'm Avery Davidson for This Week in Louisiana Agriculture.
Commissioner Strain says he's working with legislators and the Jindal administration to make sure the assessments cotton farmers pay for the boll weevil eradication's maintenance program money remains safe.